Good morning and welcome to Vlogmas week 3. I'm so excited that we've been doing Vlogmas for a couple weeks now and I've actually continued doing it. So pretty proud of myself for that. But today is my last day in Wisconsin, so feeling pretty sad, not gonna lie. I cried quite a bit yesterday and I feel it's gonna happen today too, but it's fine. It's just life, you know? But I thought today I would just kind of do a vlog of just the day, what I'm doing, just kind of make it a nice casual vlogging day. So this morning I woke up and I had some breakfast, I had some Greek yogurt, and then I finished editing my week 2 for Vlogmas, so that'll be up tonight. So hopefully you all tune in for that one too. But then I've just been sitting here watching Megan Grubb's Vlogmas that just came out this morning, so I was excited to watch that because it came out literally as soon as I was done editing my video. I was like, oh my god, it's 11, I can watch it now. So I was excited, so I'm watching that. And then I think I'm gonna after this is done pop downstairs to their fitness room that they have here and walk on the treadmill for half an hour, because I'm really not just feeling like I have it in me to do a big workout. Just mentally, emotionally, I'm not there, not with it, but I feel like it'll make my body feel better and it'll get some endorphins flowing, which will be good for me to have, especially since tomorrow I'll be flying most of the day and won't have time to get any real movement in. So I think it'll be good to start the day. Well, I guess not start the day, it's almost noon at this point, but it took a while to edit the YouTube video. But yeah, so I'm just gonna head downstairs in a couple minutes to walk on the treadmill. Okay, here's the fit we threw on to go walk on the treadmill. We have my Everyday Optimist crew neck, some joggers, and then I put on my Whitney Simmons crop tank for when I get a little hot while I'm walking, just to be able to throw this off. So it's taking me a while to work up the motivation to do this, but we're gonna do it. So yeah. I finished my walk. Like I said before, releasing the endorphins and getting moving definitely made me feel a little bit better. I'm not as gloomy and down right now. I mean, that'll probably change tonight when Jordan gets back, but for now, during the day, I feel good. I feel a little bit better. I'm ready to get a shower, make some lunch, and I have to pack, so that'll be kind of sad, but I have 10 days worth of clothes that I have to put back in the suitcase, so not gonna be very fun, but we'll see how it goes. All right, we have my pizza, my buffalo dip, and my chips. I'm gonna be watching some Parks and Rec. So obviously this lunch is not the healthiest at all, but right now he doesn't have any more fruits and vegetables or whatever because we ate them all. So today I just kind of am making do, and that's okay. I'm not gonna get too stressed out about the fact that I don't have any fruits or veggies today. It's one day. And then when I get home tomorrow, I'll have plenty, so it's no biggie. I'm gonna enjoy this pizza and dip because I love it. So I'm gonna actually enjoy it and not feel too guilty about it. Sad. It really sucks, you know, leaving and not getting to live in the same place as my boyfriend, you know? But Christmas is coming up, so he'll be home in a couple weeks, which will be nice. And then we'll get to hang out, spend some time together then, which will be a lot of fun, but it still is hard leaving, and, you know, because it's different when we're here. And you know, it's just us. Like, there's no family, no friends from home, like, nobody else, like, that I have to, you know, compete with, I guess, for his attention. So, not like it's, like, competing, but, like, you know, there's no one else to divide his attention. I'm all he can focus on. I don't know, maybe that's narcissistic of me, I don't know. But definitely feeling a little bit sad, so I think I might, what time is it? Let me see. Stupid watch. Okay, so it's like 3:15 now. He'll be home in like 1.5 to 2 hours. So I feel like maybe I will do some like drawing in my like coloring book that I have, because I was like doing that and watching TV. And I might go down to watch the sunset at the lake. I haven't decided for sure yet, but you guys will obviously see if I decide to do that. Okay, I'm gonna go watch the sunset. I'm pretty excited. It's like such a beautiful day out. I don't know why I got so lucky, but I did. It's not even that cold out, so fingers crossed it's a beautiful sunset. Good evening, everybody. So I've made it for the sunset. It's really pretty. So here I show you guys. I'm not in the greatest location yet, but hold on. It's freaking amazing. So yeah, there you go. You got the most beautiful sunset you've probably ever seen. Alright, so I think that's where I'm going to end it today. Storm's going to be home in a little bit, and I just want to spend some time with him my last night here. So I will be showing you all kind of my flying day tomorrow, and then I'll probably talk to you again Wednesday. Guys, it's Wednesday and I'm back home with Miss Luna. Yeah, baby, mommy's home, isn't she? Isn't mommy home? Because mommy loves her Luna. Yes, she does. Yeah, so I'm home with Luna now, and I filmed a little bit of my trip yesterday. You don't need to see that. And I hope you guys kind of enjoyed seeing my day flying. I was kind of sad all day, obviously, because leaving Jordan, I always feel pretty sad. But we're home now, and he'll be home in like 2 weeks for Christmas. So, you know, it's fine, but it's always hard saying goodbye and stuff. So today I thought, why not do my makeup with you? Because I have a hair appointment in a little bit, and I'm really gonna switch it up. So thought, why not show you guys the process of getting ready for it. So obviously I'm not going to do anything to my hair, because that would be counterproductive. But I'm just going to put on some makeup and kind of get ready. And this is, I'll show you guys my outfit also. Right now, you can obviously see my basic tank, but I have this cute little zip-up jacket that I'm going to put over it, that I just got from H&M. I got it in their Black Friday sale, and I love shopping at H&M because a lot of their like material that they use is recycled, and you can see like when you're buying something how much is recycled and where the material comes from. So I really love that about it. So I really do like shopping at H&M, because because I try to be as sustainable as possible in my life. You know, I'm not obviously super great at it, but I do try to like make sustainable choices where I can, and that's one place that I do. Like, the fashion world is already so like harmful to the environment and things, so I try to do my part in that way by shopping at like H&M, or like going to Play-Dohs and thrifting, or like just doing things like that, which obviously I still buy like new things from like American Eagle or Aerie or like other places sometimes. But you know, every change that you make, even if it's a little one, is impactful, so make those changes. Okay, so to start, I'm gonna be using the Supergoop Glow Screen. Please stop. Do not touch that. No. That's not Luna's. Okay. Thank you. Yep, this is great. Why are you all up in my face? Stop! Mommy said no. That's no. Can you please back up, ma'am? Ma'am, go play with your toys. So, sunscreen is on. Luna loves these. She loves beauty blenders. So she's like scouting out right now, trying to get it from me. Like, she keeps taking it. Luna, it's not yours. She loves these things. And the problem is, I have an extra that I would be fine giving her, but then I don't want her to associate the beauty blender with a toy, you know? So, no. Next thing, this is a new product that I got recently because, I know, baby, I love you. Because Megan Grubb uses this, she swears by it, and they were having like a sale where you could get it, and I got it on Black Friday. It's very expensive, honestly, it's like really expensive, but I got it in this like set. I got a big one and a travel one. I got them both for $70, which like I think one of these is normally like $80, so it's pretty good. But it was like $70 like with, and then like the discount was like 20% off of that. So it was like a really good deal. Obviously very pricey, but I had been saving up some money over the past couple months for Black Friday because I was like, okay, I'm gonna treat myself on Black Friday, get some things that I normally wouldn't buy. And this container is huge. I haven't actually used it yet, but you're gonna see what it looks like here today. Because I did kind of try it out last night just to see what it was. And it's like very tan. So I tanned last night to see if like that made it look kind of more natural, but let's see. So, it's called a glowing base. Obviously, it made me look a little bit tanner, a little bit more glowy. I'm still kind of like figuring out how to apply it in the best way, how much to apply. I think I did too much, but when I look at it in my normal mirror, it doesn't look like crazy, so I think it's fine, especially because I'm gonna put stuff on top of it. It was just a glowing base. So let's see how this works with other products. So I'm doing my eyebrows now, which I also didn't show you guys because I didn't bring my stuff to Madison, but I have this like brow soap thing from Amazon, and then I spray my little thing with this hyaluronic spray, and then I go in the soap, get it all up in there, and then I just brush up. Okay, so that one's done, and obviously it kind of looks the same, but I do this because it holds them in place, because normally sometimes they'll like, you know, fall down like that, or like, you know, so at least doing this to my eyebrows helps keep them in place. And she is really getting into everything right now. She's like, I don't care, Mom. I'm gonna just be up in your face all morning. To be fair, she missed me, and I missed her more than anything, so we're both kind of working through our feelings about missing each other right now. Yeah, okay, thank you. Oh my god, she almost knocked it over. Okay, So that's kind of how I do my eyebrows. I don't ever fill them in or anything, because look at them. Does it look like I need to fill in my eyebrows? No, I do not. I like tried, like when I was like in high school and I was like a big thing to fill in your eyebrows, and I looked like a freaking psychopath, because why would you fill in your eyebrows if you already, seriously, ma'am, this is not for you, not for you, not for you. Why would you fill in your eyebrows if you already have big bushy eyebrows, you know? Okay, here we go. We're gonna do a little bit of a foundation now. So I'm gonna use my CoverGirl Skin Milk. Okay, yeah, I know you're excited too. We're just doing the makeup together. Yay for us! Yay, 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 doing makeup together. Okay, foundation is done, and I think it kind of helped make the glowing base, like by Terry CC Serum, look a little bit more like toned down. I don't know, I like it. I like how the base interacts with the foundation. This is really nice. I like it. I think it looks really good. Spectacular. Okay, so now I'm just gonna do my concealer. Because we're not like trying to do like a super like full face look. We're just trying to cover the bases. Would you please stop? So I apply my concealer. And then I just put it where I get a little bit more spottiness, which is obviously all over my freaking face. Okay, so that's my concealer. That's how I kind of put that on. I rely heavily on concealer. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Okay. Eyebrows are moving around. Okay, now we're gonna do some setting powder. I don't know if I talked about setting powder either. I do it sometimes, and it just depends on my mood, I guess. I don't do like a ton. I just do it like around where I put my concealer, obviously, like my T-zone, you know? I know, baby. What's mommy doing? I know you want it. Sorry. I feel like it just kind of like helps it sit more naturally, you know? When you put a little bit of like powder on, and just make sure it doesn't look like I don't like when I look too like powdery, but I like this stuff. I've been using it for years. What is it? Maybelline Lasting Fix. It's the like all day matte finish loose setting powder. It's pretty nice. It's also nice for when you're actually like contouring and whatever, you put it underneath there. I saw people do that, so I tried it. I thought it was cool. Okay, now I'm gonna do blush with obviously my Rare Beauty blush. There's blush. Now time for some highlighter with my, obviously, my Rare Beauty highlight. Okay, highlighter's done. Okay, now for my eyes, I'm just gonna use my Wet n Wild highlighter like I told you I do last week. As you can see, I also apply everything with my finger for the most part. I just like how things look more, I think, when I apply it with my hands. And I also feel like I don't break out as much from makeup when I use my fingers. Which I get it, clean your brushes, whatever, like I do, but like I feel like it's easier for me to clean my hands than it is for me to clean my brushes like all the time.
Now for mascara. I'm gonna use my CoverGirl tried and true. Okay, so mascara is done. Now we're gonna do lips. So obviously I have a lot of makeup on my lips, so I'm gonna go wipe it off. So for lips, I think I'm just gonna do lip liner and then a little bit of lipstick. Okay, so last step is I like to just spray my face a little bit with the Hyaluronic Fix spray. Just because I feel like it kind of makes it look a little bit more dewy. And I like that look, so yeah, this is my makeup. I'm wearing jeans and just my Nike court shoes, but this is the part I'm excited about. Look at this jacket. I don't know if you can tell. It's got like a little faux fur hood and like it's the same on the sleeves. Just looks really cute. I really like it. So this is what I'm gonna wear. So I will come back and show you guys my hair after I get it done. So should we do a little transition? Okay. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Okay, here it is. What do we think? Obviously, it's very different. I just kind of was feeling like this was something I've always wanted to try with my hair, see if I like it. And so I was like, why not do it? Why let the fear of something, you know, not looking as you plan or not looking great, like keep you from trying something? Like, I'm trying it. Now, I don't know if I love it or not yet. I think I like it at least, but I'm giving it a try, and my hair will grow out if I want to keep it longer again, and I can always dye it back brown. Like, it's just hair. So, yeah, here it is. All right, well, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Good morning. It's gonna be the last day of Vlogmas for week 3. So today we're doing Christmas with my mom's family, and I'm gonna just kinda show you some clips from the day. I'm not gonna be too like talky vloggy, but like you'll just get to see kind of what's going on during the day, which I'm excited about because we got some fun things planned. So yeah, also, what do we think? I think I'm liking it more than I did originally. I think I'm vibing with it, you know, my hair. Okay, well, I hope you enjoy getting to see how we spend Christmas today.
Pack it in your suitcase, so it's not like you have a big thing.
That's one of those ones where they said it goes over the counter.
I didn't see it. You see, Jackson is out today. They just announced it. Lamar.
Oh, look at this.
Oh!
Yeah, that's a nice gift. I like that. I don't remember this stuff. Ooh, hot cocoa and cream fragrance. And of course, I got candy too.
There's a candle that's
on. So that wraps up week 3 of Vlogmas. I hope you guys enjoyed this week. I'm gonna finish up the night with some hot cocoa and some Love Island on the TV. So I hope that you guys will tune back in for week 4 next week, the final week of Vlogmas.